Dear student, welcome to the second semester. Same like previous one, in this semester you are going to learn applied science. Okay, applied science, it consists of two part. First is applied physics and second is the applied chemistry. Course code for this course is 22202. This is the course code. Okay, so same like previous semester, first three chapters from the physics and fourth, fifth, sixth, these are from the applied chemistry. Okay, so chapter number four, it is the metals, alloys, cement and refractory material. This is our chapter number four. Okay, and same like previous one, weightage is also same, 35 marks for the physics, 35 for the chemistry and total is of 70 marks. Okay, let's proceed further. We will see the course outcome. So what is the course outcome of this chapter number 4? After learning this chapter, student will be able to select relevant metallurgical processes related to the industrial application. Okay, means when you are complete, after learning this chapter, completion of this chapter, students will be able to select relevant metallurgical process, means which, suppose sulfide ore is given to you, which metallurgical process you are going to select, or oxide ore is given to you, which treatment you are going to give that ore. All that after completing this chapter, you are going to know which process should be applied for that. Okay, and total teaching hour for this chapter is 12 hours and weightage is also the 12 marks out of 35. 12 marks is for this chapter number 4. Okay, in this video, I am going to cover the basic terminology which is involved in the metallurgy. Okay, so what is a metallurgy? Metallurgy, it is the art and science which includes the extraction of metal. Here we are going to cover the terminology of metallurgy. So before to proceed, first I will explain what is metallurgy. Metallurgy, it is nothing but which involves the extraction of metal. It involves the extraction of metal. Okay, you are knowing metal we are getting from the nature, it is in the form of ore, and from ore it is getting from the mineral. Okay, so from that mineral, how metal is extracted, and that extraction of metal economically and profitably, that process or that art, it is called the metallurgy. Okay, so in this video, I am going to cover the basic terminology which is involved in the metallurgy. Okay, so let us proceed further. See, first term, that is the mineral. What is mineral? Mineral, the naturally occurring substance present in the earth crust which contains metal either in free state or combined state, it is called the mineral. Okay, so minerals, mineral means which is occurring in the nature. Okay, in the earth crust it is present, which contains the metal, how it is, either in the free state or in the combined state. Mineral, mineral means jo bhi earth crust mein present hota hai, naturally, naturally occurring substance which is present in the earth crust, jo bhi earth crust mein present hota hai, jisme kya hona chahiye, metal hona chahiye, or that metal, how they are present in that earth crust, either in the free state or in combined state. Free state, mostly our, what to say, gold, silver, platinum, these noble metals, they occur in the free state. Free state means they are not combined with any other. Okay, singly they are single, they are occurring in the nature single. Okay, combined state means, take the example of your zinc, zinc sulfide. Zinc metal, it is combined with the sulfur. So this is zinc sulfide. Okay, calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Here calcium is combined with carbon and oxygen. So these are in combined state. Iron, Fe2O3. Here iron, it is combined with the oxygen. So these metals, active metals, mostly occur in the combined state. Whereas precious metal, noble metals, less active metal, they occur in the free state. Okay, so clear. Mineral, mineral means jo bhi nisarga mein available hota hai, अर्थ क्रस्ट में जो भी प्रेजेंट होता है, जिसमें क्या प्रेजेंट होना चाहिए, मेटल. कैसा होता है मेटल? आइदर इन फ्री स्टेट और कंबाइंड स्टेट, इट इज कॉल्ड द मिनरल. ओके, हियर आर द फ्यू इमेजेस ऑफ द मिनरल व्हिच इज ऑकरिंग इन द नेचर. ओके, यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज द एजुराइट, क्वार्ट्ज इज हियर, कोबाल्ट कैल्साइट इज हियर, यू कैन एक्सट्रैक्ट द कोबाल्ट फ्रॉम दैट. सो हियर आर द फ्यू इमेजेस ऑफ द मिनरल. नाउ नेक्स्ट टर्म, सेकेंड टर्म, दैट इज द ओर. सो वॉट इज ओर? ओर मीन्स अ मिनरल फ्रॉम विच मेटल कैन बी एक्सट्रैक्टेड इकोनॉमिकली एंड प्रॉफिटेबली, इट इज कॉल्ड द ओर. ओके, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव यू वन एग्जाम्पल हियर. सी, फर्स्ट वी हैव सीन द, वॉट वी हैव सीन, मिनरल. मिनरल बोले तो वॉट एवर प्रेजेंट इन द नेचर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कॉल इट एज अ मिनरल. ओके, बट इट मस्ट कंटेन द मेटल. नाउ सी हियर, क्ले. क्ले इट इज ऑल्सो ऑकरिंग द, ऑकरिंग इन द नेचर, ऑकरिंग इन द अर्थ क्रस्ट. वट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ दैट क्ले? द फॉर्मूला ऑफ क्ले, इट इज द Al2O3. लेट मी टेक द पेन. Al2O3 SiO2 3H2O. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ क्ले. एंड नाउ इफ आई डिसाइडेड टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द एल्यूमिनियम फ्रॉम दिस, इफ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सट्रैक्ट इट, यू आर गोइंग टू गेट ओनली 10 to 20% ऑफ एल्यूमिनियम फ्रॉम दिस क्ले. सो वेदर इट इज इकोनॉमिकल? नो, दिस इज नॉट द इकोनॉमिकल वन. ओके, सो जिस मिनरल से हमें प्रॉफिटेबली इकोनॉमिकली मेटल मिलता है उसे ही हम क्या बोलने वाले हैं? ओर बोलने वाले. नाउ हियर क्ले, क्ले इट इज नॉट द ओर. ओके, क्ले इज नॉट द ओर बट इट इज द मिनरल. ओके, गेटिंग टू मी? क्ले क्या है? क्ले मिनरल है, ये ओर नहीं है. क्योंकि हम इससे एल्यूमिनियम एक्सट्रैक्ट करने का बोलेंगे तो क्या इसमें से कितना परसेंट मिलेगा हमें? 10 to 20% तक ही एल्यूमिनियम मिलेगा. इतना तो उसका सेटअप करने में ही हमारा ज्यादा पैसा वेस्ट चला जाएगा. सो इट इज नॉट द इकोनॉमिकल एंड प्रॉफिटेबल वन. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट, सो मेनी टाइम्स क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड इन एमसीक्यू, ऑल ओर्स आर मिनरल्स बट ऑल मिनरल्स आर नॉट ओर, ट्रू और फॉल्स? यू हैव टू स्टेट वेदर इट इज ट्रू और फॉल्स. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन फर्स्ट, देन यू हैव टू आंसर मी दिस. ऑल ओर्स आर मिनरल्स बट ऑल मिनरल्स आर नॉट ओर. ओके, सी, ऑल ओर्स आर मिनरल, ऑल ओर्स आर मिनरल. आर यू एग्री विद दिस? ऑल ओर्स आर मिनरल, राइट? और सभी ओर्स क्या है? मिनरल्स है. यस, सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज द करेक्ट. बट ऑल मिनरल्स आर नॉट ओर. जस्ट आई हैव गिवन यू द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ क्ले. ओके, क्ले इट इज द मिनरल बट इट इज नॉट द ओर. सो ऑल मिनरल्स आर नॉट ओर. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज द ट्रू. हाउ इट इज? नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू. Take the example of clay and bauxite. Just I have given you the example of clay. What is the formula of clay? Formula of clay is Al2O3. Yes. Yes. Formula of clay is Al2O3, 2SiO2, 2H2O. This is the formula of clay. And bauxite, the formula of bauxite is Al2O3, 2H2O. Now see here, if you want to extract the aluminium from clay, you are going to get only 10 to 20% of aluminium. While when you want to extract the aluminium from the bauxite, that time you are going to get 60 to 70% of aluminium. Now tell me, which one is economical one? From where you are going to get the profitable amount of aluminium? From bauxite or from clay? See, from clay you are getting only 10 to 20%. And from bauxite you are getting the 60 to 70%. So from bauxite it is the economical and profitable one. So here you can say these both, clay and bauxite, both are the minerals, right? Both are the mineral, both are occurring naturally in the earth crust. Dono bhi nisarga mein present hote, naturally they are occurring in the earth crust. But you can extract aluminium economically and profitably from bauxite and not from the clay. So you can call bauxite as a ore. So you can call this bauxite as a ore, and clay is the ore? No, clay is the mineral, because it is not, you are not getting the metal from this clay, economical one and profitable one. So this is the mineral and this is the ore. Okay, so So here it is explained here, clay and bauxite are the minerals of aluminium, but aluminium can be economically and profitably extracted from the bauxite and not from clay. Hence clay is the mineral while bauxite is the ore. Okay. Next, gang. Next term is the gang. What is gang? The earthy, rocky, unwanted impurity which is associated with the ore, it is called the gang or matrix. Okay, it is also called the matrix. So you are getting the ore from the mines, right? Mine means क्या बोलते हैं खान जो होती है ना, खान में से मिलता है आपको. यू आर गेटिंग दैट फ्रॉम द माइन. सो व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग दैट ओर, इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द रॉकी और द इम्प्यूरिटीज विद इट. ओके, सो दैट अर्दी रॉकी विच इज नॉट यूजफुल, विच इज अनवांटेड, अनवांटेड इम्प्यूरिटी, इट इज कॉल्ड द गैंग और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द मैट्रिक्स. नेक्स्ट इज द फ्लक्स. व्हाट इज फ्लक्स? फ्लक्स इट इज द सब्सटेंस. It is used to remove gang or matrix from the ore. जो substance gang or matrix remove करने के लिए, ore में जो कुछ भी gang और matrix present होता है उसे remove करने के लिए जो substance use करते हैं उसे हम क्या बोलने वाले हैं? Flux बोलने वाले हैं. Okay? So next, types of flux. There are the two types of flux. One is acidic flux, basic flux. So acidic flux, example of acidic flux is SiO2, जिसे सिलिका बोलते हैं. Basic flux CaO, lime, FeO, these are the example of basic flux. So when to use this acidic flux? If your impurities are the basic, that time you have to use the acidic flux. Again I am going to repeat, if your impurities are basic, that time you have to use the acidic flux. And if your impurities are acidic in nature, gang or matrix, it is acidic in nature, that time you have to use the basic flux. Okay, so example of basic flux CaO, FeO, these are the example of basic flux. And acidic flux, example of acidic flux is SiO2. So here again I have explained this acidic flux, which is used to remove basic gang, basic flux, the basic flux which is used to remove the acidic gang. Okay, see here, here it is calcium oxide, basic flux it is, and your acidic gang, silica, you are not knowing sand, the formula of sand is also SiO2, sand it is also present, it is associated with your ore, so here it is acting as a gang, which is acidic in nature, so this gang is acidic, so you have to use the basic flux, CaO, when these two combine, that time CaSiO3, CaSiO3, calcium silicate is formed. That calcium silicate, it is called the slag. Here again, acidic flux, silica, ferrous oxide, this is basic gang. When both they combine, FeSiO3, ferrous silicate, FeSiO3, ferrous silicate is formed. Okay. Next, we are going to start next term, that is the slag. What is slag? Now, gang plus flux, both they combine together to form the fusible mass, it is called the slag. The fusible mass formed by the combination of flux and gang. Flux and gang, both they combine together in the molten state. This fusible means in the molten state they are forming at the top of that hearth. Okay, top of that well, it is called the slag. So what is slag? Slag, it is nothing but the combination of flux and gang, it is called the slag. Okay, so this is about the basic terminology which is involved in the metallurgy. Thank you.